Good morning. So we are in the discussion of the different non-traditional machining process. So in the last class, we completed the abrasive jet machining, abrasive water jet machining, ultrasonic machining, and electrochemical machining. So in this class, we will learn about what is meant by a thermal machining process. Because in thermal machining process is also very, very important thing, which is going to be used for a very hard materials, for those the materials which cannot be machined easily. So the under the thermal machining process, it going to be getting as electron beam machining and a laser beam machining. So we'll see that. So electron beam machining, by the name electron beam machining, it explains that with the help of an electrons, the electrons are going to passing on the workpiece and the workpiece is going to be get melted at a certain point when the electrons are striking on the workpiece. So we'll see one by one. So what is meant by electron beam machining and when it is going to be get started? So the history of the electron beam machining. So why the electron beam machining, why the thermal machining process are considered is, it is due to, because when it is having a very hard materials, we can't cut it. So for those type of materials, we are going to passing down the electrons with the help of some type of laser beams, or else by using an EBM, if the materials is to be get melted at a certain point. So how it is to be get melted? So this is the discovery that a beam of electrons has ability to melt the materials coincided with the discovery of X-ray tube in a late 1800s. So it was discovered in the point of 1800s. So in 1940s, individuals of the manufacturing community began to consider the possibility of using electron beam for performing various fabrication tasks. So the, at the time of 1940s, they used to for the help of the fabrication part. So in 1947, a Germany company designed a prototype machine for an EBM. So they had designed a part, which is nothing but a machine at the point of, it was at, by Germany company in 1947. So in 1952, first electron beam machine for use as a welding tool was built at Carl Zeiss GmbH. So in 1959, so first true electron beam welding machines became available in USA. From it is around 1959, all the electron beam machines are to be get available from in the market. So the thing is, so what is the principle of the electron beam machining? Why the name electron beam machining? You had got it. So here you are going to be having a workpiece, you are going to be having a tool. So in this, the main point is you are going to be maintaining a vacuum chamber. You are going to be maintaining a vacuum chamber. Why the vacuum chamber is? Because the electrons are to be get passing down towards the workpiece. So when the electrons are passing towards the workpiece, the air cannot be get disturbed the electrons. If the air is to be get disturbed the electrons, the shape, the deflection is to be get motivated, the deflection is to be get happen. So not to be get deflected, it is to be kept in a total vacuum chamber. So the vacuum chamber, so the principle is a thermal process which uses a focused beam of high velocity electrons to perform a high speed drilling and cutting operations. So this is used for a high speed drilling and cutting operations. So when high velocity electrons strike the workpiece, their kinetic energy is converted into the heat necessary for rapid melting and vaporization. So the thing is, the kinetic energy of the electron beam depends on the mass and the velocity. Depends on the mass and the velocity of electrons. So though the mass of an electron is only, but it can attain the velocity of a certain speed of light. And the process of heating by an electron beam can be used for annealing, welding, or machining electron beams as focused at a point. And it is the means of the magnetic fields, and the power density can be at a high of 6.5 × 10^12. So the thing, the principle totally explains that here the kinetic energy is converted into the heat, which is necessary for rapid melting and the vaporization of any material. So in this, the total the arrangement is, in the vacuum chamber, you are placing the workpiece and you are going to be having an anode, you are going to be having a cathode. So this totally done with the help of a power supply, a DC power. So here one is connected with the positive terminal and another is connected with the negative terminal. So the connection where the supply is to be get carried out is known as an electron gun. So in between, when the electrons are to be get passing due to the power supply, here a diaphragm, a grid cup is to be get attached. Here this shape is nothing but a grid cup, which is going to be attached. So the power supply is to be given for the grid cup. So from the grid cup, the electrons are to be get generated. And this generation is to be get altering towards the diaphragm. And it is going to be get striking towards the workpiece. And between the diaphragm and the workpiece, there is a deflection path. So why the deflection lens are to be placed is so that the electrons which are going to be striking towards the workpiece cannot deviate, of any of the size or any of the side, so that it directly strikes the workpiece. Clear? This is a total overview of the EBM process. Okay, so the principle is the kinetic energy is converted into a heat necessary for a rapid melting. So you will see the next slide. So EBM is precisely controlled vaporization process. So as you are going to be seeing, it is the melting. So it is explained as it is a vaporization process. The most of the EBM process are performed in a high 10 vacuum chamber to ensure the optimum beam propagation and focusing. So I had told you the total arrangement machine was placed in a vacuum. So you have to get it out. Why the vacuum is to be get needed? So I already told you the total process is done with the help of an electrons. So when the electrons are to be get passing over to the workpiece, some air is to be get striking on the electrons. So to control that air, the total machine is placed in a vacuum chamber. So the since the electrons have mass, they interact with the air molecules, which results in beam dispersion and the large loss of energy. To avoid the collision of the accelerating electrons with the air molecules, vacuum is necessary. So use of vacuum also prevents the molten material in the machining zone from spreading into the surrounding environment. So it is also one of the advantages, so that the electrons cannot be get deviated from the machine and cannot be get striking over the total surroundings also. So it won't be get disturbed the total surrounding. So what is going to be happening on the workpiece, it is at only the certain point. So it can be taken example of certain welding process also. When we are going to be using some gas welding, what we will do, the glass welding is to be done on a certain place. It is not to be get placed in an environment. It is not to be get done. It is totally a dark room. We are going to perform an operation. Similarly, here also it is going to be happening. Okay. So the next one. So what is the summary of an EBM? So what is the parameters they are going to be using? So the what is the use of an electron beam? So why the electron beam is to be used? One is the welding. The second is the machining. Under the machining, it is getting a cutting and drilling. So the first prototype is at 1947. So etching. So in the yesterday class, I already explained you, I had already shown you what is the etching designs. What is the etching design on, and it is also done on the glass fibers. So, and the heat treatment. So what are the materials that can be cut? So what type of materials can be cut? The diamond, carbide, ceramic oxide, and other very hard materials, metals and plastics. So basically the EBM is used for the hard materials, for the hard materials. So for that sake only it is known as a thermal machining process. It is not a normal unconventional machining process. It comes under the thermal machining process. Clear? So the basis for using electron. So why the electrons are to be used? So electrons can be formed into small beam using an electric field. So with the help of a power supply, DC power supply, and with the help of a grids, the electrons are to be get generated. So from the which the electrons are generated, it is accelerating towards the diaphragm and towards the deflection coils. So electrons can be accelerated. So electrons can be focused and bent using an electrostatic and electromagnetic fields. Clear? So these are the things which we are going to be placing in the total machine. So the parameters like accelerating voltage. So what is the voltage we are going to be taking? So the details is 50 to 200 kilowatts. So what is the beam current? It is 100 to 1000 amperes. What is the power? 0.5 to 50 kilowatts. What is the pulse duration? 4 to 65. Pulse frequency 0.1 to 16,000 hertz. Vacuum 10 power minus 2 to 10 power minus 5 mm per HD. So beam spot size minimum it is 12 to 25. So beam power density it is 1.55 to into 10 power 5 to 1.55 into 10 power 9. So beam deflection angle 6.5 mm square. So tool, the beam of the high velocity electrons. Work materials, all materials which are very hard. So maximum MRR, so 10. So not only the hard materials, we can also take any of the materials. It preferably used for a hard material. So you can take any of the materials. But when you are using an EBM or LBM, it is very expensive. It is not a very cheap. It is very, very expensive because some type of arrangement is to be get placed. It is not a directly tool we are using. So the specific power consumption, it is 450. So the critical parameters, so the accelerating voltage, beam current, pulse duration, spot diameter, beam deflection signal, work speed, and the melting temperature. So in the diagram, already told you, the total, it is going to be happen with the help of a power. So what is the voltage we are giving? What is the current supplying is going to be get done? So what is the pulse duration? What is the frequency? So what type of vacuum chamber you had selected? And in what size, in what shape the electrons are to be get accelerated on the workpiece? What is the size of the electrons? So up to what extent it is going to be accelerating on the workpiece? So what is the power density? What is the deflection angle? So I had already told you, the deflection is to be get placed when the electrons are to be traveling over to the workpiece. So the what is the tool and what is the material and what is the MR? Clear, students? So these are the basic parameters which are to be used under an EBM process. So the next one. So this is an EBM equipment. So as I had told you, voltage cable, DC, and this is a grid cup. So this is a grid cup, a blue single. Wait a second. We already written it as cathode cathode grid. So it is connected to a cathode, and after the grid we are having the anode, and after that you are having the deflection coils. I already told you what is the deflection coils, why the deflection coils are to be get maintained. So above the deflection coils, the magnetic lens and the optical viewing system, you are going to see whether the electrons are to be going in a correct manner or not. So how it is to be get done? So the viewing port. So here in a vacuum chamber on a work table, the work piece is to be get placed. So the vacuum chamber is must and should. It is must and should. Clear? So this is the total diagram, the perfect diagram of an EBM, the machine. So now we will see what it consists of. So an equipment is contained in vacuum 10 to 4. In order to ensure the cutting energy, electron source is an electric gun, electron gun, several times the intensity of a TV gun. So an electron gun is basically triode consists of, so what is meant by electron gun? So it is a cathode to emit high negative potential electrons. It is a grid cup negatively biased with respect to cathode, and it is an anode at ground potential. So cathode is made from tungsten filament. So we have to know what is made up of. So what is a grid made up of? It is made up of a tungsten filament, and it is heated to 2500 to 3000 degrees Celsius to emit the electrons, because from the tungsten filament only we are going to be getting the electrons. Electrons are to be get emitted from it. So at what extent it is to be get heated? So emission of current, it is 25 to 100 amperes depending on the cathode material. So there is a difference between the different types of cathode materials to be get selected when the different types of work pieces are to be get taken. So what is the current density for accelerating the voltage? So what is the electrons are accelerated using the potential between the cathode and an anode? So electrons, how they are going to be accelerated? So the accelerated electrons are focused by the grid cup. Yes, from the grid cup only the electrons are to be get generated. See here, from the grid cup only. And these rays are to be get coming in a correct manner, not it is deflecting. It is striking directly on the workpiece in a correct manner. So the electrons will flow through the anode. After existing the anode, the electrons are refocused using the magnetic and electrostatic lenses controlled by the beam direction. So with the help of these magnetic lens and the deflections, and with the help of the shape of a vacuum chamber, what we are going to maintaining, the electrons are to be deviated. So electrons maintain the speed in excess of half of the speed of the light because they move in vacuum. So no collision environment until it hit the workpiece in a small circuit of approximately 0.025 mm. Clear? So the cutting path can be controlled by diverting the electron beam or by moving the work table. So cutting path means we have to cut a certain shape in a certain size. So what the shape can be get generated on the workpiece? So it is to be get generated when the work table is to be get moved somewhat in a forward direction or somewhat in a backward direction. So they are telling that cutting path can be controlled by diverting the electron beam or moving the table. So next one. So this is the industrial electron beam machining. So in the industry, what type of electron beam machinings we are going to be using? We had seen just now, it is a small machine. It is a very, very small machine. But in an industry, this type of things is to be get used. So now we will see what are the parts in an industry it is going to be having. So one is a oil cooled cathode insulator. So this is, so next, it is a power supply and electrodes, you know, in the normal machine, and a gun pumping port and a solid gun column. This is a solid gun column. And access door. So we are going to be accessing from here. We are seeing whether it is accessing in a correct manner or not. So iron trap, next TV camera, next valve actuator, next a glass and a metal vapor shield actuator. So both the actuators are to be used here. So viewing assembly, so vapor shield, lens coil and deflection coil. And it is an optical viewing. And this is a vacuum chamber. And this is a workpiece where it is to be get placed. It's totally a vacuum chamber. So a vacuum pump. And it is not a vacuum chamber, means we are going to pumping something. So it is going to be having a vacuum pump also. So workpiece holder. Workpiece holder is nothing but it is just like a fixture. Workpiece holder. So these are the different parts when compared to the normal machine. So because this type of machines are to be used for number of production systems, so this type of industrial electron beam machining is to be get used. Okay, so we will see the power supply. So to generate a very high voltage up to 150 kilowatts to accelerate the electrons, so to the electron beam gun to generate the shape and deflect the electron beam to machine the workpiece. Next, a vacuum system to facilitate the generation and travel of the electron beam and causing machining to take place in a vacuum chamber. So here they are explaining why the use of a vacuum system. So what is a work positioning system? For controlled manipulation of the work piece position, may be simple as single motor driven rotary axis. So it must have some diversion also. The workpiece what you are going to place, it is fixed continuously, but if you want some type of design to be get implemented on a workpiece, it must be in a position to be get moved also. So we can have that type of arrangements for moving of a workpiece. So as complex as a fully CNC, closed loop and five axis system. So these are the different things which was happening in an EBM. So we will see what is the applications of EBM. So before we will see the applications, we will see what is the animation of EBM. Okay. So this is a vacuum chamber. The black, the total black is a vacuum chamber. The high voltage cable, this is a high voltage cable which is connected to a power supply. And this is a grid cup I had shown you. And this acts like a cathode. And beside to the grid cup, you are having an anode and you are having a diaphragm. It is an optical viewing system. We are seeing whether the electrons are moving in a correct manner or not. And this is the magnetic lens placed in between the deflection coil and a diaphragm. So the deflection coil and the workpiece. So these are the main parts which are to be taken in EBM. So the fixture, we are going to fixing the workpiece. So when the high voltage of 30 kilowatts, it nearly explains to the DC power, when it is generated to the cathode grid cup, some type of electrons are to be get generated. So from the electrons are to be accelerated towards the anode and from the diaphragm and from the magnetic lens towards the workpiece. So the anode and the diaphragm and the magnetic lens, those are placed in a such a manner so that the electron rays is to be moved directly striking to the workpiece. Clear? So we are having a magnetic lens, we are having a deflection coil. So this is the workpiece and a fixture. Okay. Now we will see what is the applications of EBM. So we had seen what is the principle of EBM, what is the process is done in an EBM, and we had also seen what is the animation of that. So the material applications, all materials those can exist in vacuum, all materials which can exist in vacuum can be used. Can be used. Next, the metals like aluminium, barium, and copper, nickel, molybdenum, titanium, and tungsten, zirconium, ferrite, and some examples. So those type of metals can be get used. And carbon and silicon alloys, and copper alloys, nickel alloys, stainless steel alloy, and the steel ceramics like glass, refractories, abrasives, ruby, sapphire, and quartz. So these are the some steel ceramics which can be get used. So composites like cemented or sintered carbides. So the plastics and leather. So these are the material applications which are to be get used. What type of materials of workpiece to be get considered. So the next one is shape applications. So what type of shapes can be get done on a workpiece? So drilling of various types of holes like an inclined hole. Shallow up to 200 micro holes, diameter less than 1 mm. So which is less than 1 mm can be get also done with the help of an EBM process, with the help of an EBM process. And drilling of a non-circular holes, tapered holes, and a high speed performance of a small diameter hose, and a 2D countering profile or blanking, 2D countering profiling or blanking. Engraving of the metals, ceramics, and vaporized layers. So machining of thin films to produce the resistor network in IC chips. So the chips which are to be get made in an different ICs. So it is to be get manufactured. Different network systems what are the chips to be get used, that is also get manufactured. So pattern generation and through cutting, thin film machining, and a surface treatment, including the surface alloying. So these are the shape applications, and these are the material applications. Here. So we'll see the next one. So what is the drilling performance of EBM? So what is the drilling performance of EBM? So what is the performance of it? So the, if you take the material of tungsten, what type of workpiece thickness must be of EBM? So what type of materials can be get selected, and how much thickness, workpiece thickness can be taken? So when the tungsten material is selected, the workpiece thickness is 0.25. The hole diameter we can produce is 0.025, and the aspect ratio is 10, and the drilling time takes less than 1. So accelerating voltage is 140, beam current is 50. So when the stainless steel, Shreds, one more thing, these drilling performance and the cutting performance is very, very useful when we are going to working in an industry. When we are working in an industry and we are going to using a non-conventional machining process under the EBM, it is very, very important. We have to know, because for all the type of materials, we can't take the same voltage, we can't use the same speed, we can't give the same speed of depth, or depth of cut also. Clear? So the stainless steel, it is 2.50, the workpiece thickness, the hole diameter is 0.125, the aspect ratio is 20, and the drilling time is 10 seconds, accelerating voltage is 140, and the beam current is 100. So even the another stainless steel can also be get the way work thickness of 1 mm. So hole diameter is 0.125, aspect ratio is 8. So when the stainless steel of 1 mm thickness is to be get taken, so the drilling time is less than 1, accelerating voltage is 140, beam current is 100. So when the aluminium 2.5 thickness, 0.125 hole diameter, 20 aspect ratio, 10, 140 and 100. So when alumina, so it is 0.75, 0.3 mm, 2.5 aspect ratio, and drilling time is 30, accelerating voltage is 125, and beam current is 60. When quartz, it is 3, and the hole diameter is 0.025 aspect ratio. Okay. And the beam current we are going to passing, it is 60, and for a quartz it is a 10. So what is the cutting performance of an EBM? So the under the cutting performance, the material what we are going to be taking, the work pieces thickness and the slot width and the cutting speed and the accelerating voltage. So when you are going to be taken the stainless steel, what is going to be happen, what is the work piece to be get taken? When the stainless steel, it is to be of 0.15, and it is the slot width is 0.1, the slot width thickness, and the cutting speed is 50, the accelerating voltage is 130, and the beam current is 50. So when you are going to be taken a tungsten, so it is a cutting performance. We are going to be explaining it as cutting performance, not as a work material. So cutting performance, the workpiece thickness is 0.05, and the slot width is 0.025, and the cutting speed is 125, and the accelerating voltage is 150, and the beam current is 30. So for the brass, the workpiece thickness and the slot width and the cutting speed, accelerating 130, and the beam current is 50. So the for an alumina, it is the workpiece thickness is 0.75, it is 0.1, it is 600, 150, and a 200. So these are the different types of the workpiece thickness and the slot width and the cutting speed and accelerating voltage is to be get taken. Clear, students? So, so these are the summary of the process capabilities and the operational characteristics of an EBM process. So the finishing capabilities and the drilling capabilities, cutting capabilities, economic aspects, and the environmental aspects. So when the finishing capabilities are to be get taken, so what type of capabilities and what is the characteristics in each and everything, we will know what is the surface roughness, what is the dimensional tolerance, what is the minimum radius and minimum overcut, minimum surface. So here these are the common values and the ranges what you are going to be taken, clear? And the drilling capabilities. So in the drilling capabilities, we are going to considering the hole diameter, aspect ratio, hole depth, and a hole taper. So here it is explains that what is the hole diameter? Diameter is nothing but what is the gap between the each and everything, and how much depth it is to be get cut. How much depth it is to be get cut, whether it is a through hole or whether it is a up to some extent. So the aspect ratio explains that what is the point of the height to the width. What is the width of the diameter? What is the height of your diameter? So up to what extent it is to be get aspected. Clear? So the what is the hole depth and what is the minimum taper? What is the minimum number of holes that can be drilled? So what is the minimum angle of inclination hole axis with surface? So these are the very important values which are there given. And the cutting capabilities. So what is the minimum width of cut? What is the thickness of the cut? What is the range of the cutting rate? So these are the values 0.025, 0.15 to 2.5 and 150. And what is the economic aspects? It is the initial investment. What is the capital cost? What is the tool and fixture cost, power and consumption cost, and a tool consumption cost. So what is the capital cost is, it is very high because it is going to be done with the help of a power supply and electron beams and magnetic lens have to be used. And what is an environmental aspects? It is very safety and toxic and contamination of machining medium. So next, and one of the main advantages, it is not having any tool wear. It is not having any tool wear. Next. So what are the advantages? So mechanical, no mechanical distortion because no cutting force during the machining. So limited thermal effects because only one pulse is used to make and pulse duration is very short. So very high drilling rates. So can drill in many different configurations. Can drill any material, that is no limitations because we had seen any type of material can be get drilled. So can drill inclined holes, so there is a no tool wear and tear. So there is no tool wear and tear. And next, it is a relatively low operating cost as compared to the other process used to produce a very small holes. And when comes to the limitations, high capital cost. Yes, high capital cost and non-productive pump downtime. So presence of a thin recast layer and high level of operator skills required. It is not to be used a normal level skilled operator. So limited to 10 mm thick materials only. So necessity for auxiliary backing material. So these are the what are the different types of comes under the EBM. Clear? So these are the different points, different principles. So after the explanation of the EBM, it takes a strikes one point is, it is used for all the types of materials and the principle is melting the material. When you are going to be striking the electron beam with the help of an electron gun, the material is to be, the workpiece is to be get melted at a certain size, at a certain direction. And what are the type of here, the cathode and anode is to be get taken and the main is vacuum is to be get considered. So these are the important points under the EBM. Okay. So now we will see what is meant by LBM. We'll go to the LBM. So what is meant by LBM process? Laser beam machining process. So this is also one of the thermal machining process because here also the beams are to be get used. It is with the help of a laser. So it is a laser beam machining process. There we are going to be used an electrons electron beam machining process. Here it is a laser light. With the help of a laser light, it is going to be getting on the workpiece. So when the laser light is to be getting on the workpiece on a certain size and shape, the material is to be get melted. Where the point it is get striking, it is to be get melted, and the workpiece is to be get designed. Clear? That is the main principle of LBM. So the LBM, it is a modern machining methods are established to fabricate difficult to machine materials such as high strength, thermal resistant alloys. So various kinds of carbides, fiber reinforced composite materials, satellites and ceramics. So convention machining of such materials produces high cutting forces. So when you are going to be using a convention machining process, we are getting a forces. So perpendicular, we are going to be getting a forces. So to control those type of cutting forces, we are going to be using an LBM process when you cut a high hardened materials. In some particular cases may not be sustained by the workpiece. So here what I had told you in the previous slide, in the EBM process. So the mechanical process are USM, AJM, WJM, AWJM. So ultrasonic machining process and abrasive jet machining, abrasive water jet machining, the total comes under the mechanical process. So electrochemical process, it is an electrochemical process, yesterday we had listened. And thermal process. Thermal process is electron discharge machining. It is wire electron discharge machining and electron beam machining and a laser beam machining. So chemical process, chemical milling and photochemical machining. So these are the main non-traditional machining process which are to be get used. So the introduction comes to the introduction. So what is meant by laser? So why the laser is to be get used? What is meant by laser? So it is nothing but a light amplification by simulated emission of radius. What we had learned in your school ages, the laser is. So a highly collimated, monochromatic and coherent light beam is generated and focused to a small spot. So high power densities are then obtained. So here also the beams, the light, due to the help of a light, it is to be get generated on the workpiece in a form of a very small diameter, and the workpiece is to be get melted and the workpiece is to be get designed. So the main components of the laser are laser active, light amplifying medium and an optical resonator, which usually consists of two mirrors. So concave mirror and convex mirror. Both the mirrors are to be get used. So next. So this is the thing, you are going to have a two mirrors at the medium and it is going to be get pumping. So with the, once we will see the diagram. Yeah. So this is a diagram, it is a total reflecting mirror. This is the chromium, it is to be just manufactured with the chromium. So this is one type of mirror and this is another type of mirror. When the power supply is to be get given and this mirrors are to be get reflected and the laser lights are to be accelerated towards the chromium basin, which was placed inside the mirrors, So when the light is to be get produced from this point and it directly strikes over to the lenses, which placed below to the chromium beam. So after that, it directly strikes over to the workpiece at a center point. So it is to be explained that it is a CNC control. It is totally a CNC control and it is an elliptical reflecting cavity. This is placed in an elliptical reflecting cavity. So here, so this is the active medium, which is taken made up of a chromium part. So the laser light is generated in an active medium of the laser. Energy is pumped into the active medium in an appropriate form and is partially transformed into a radiation energy. So the principle is it is transformed into a radiation energy, what the energy is to be get pumping from the part. So the energy pumped into the active medium is usually highly entropic and it is very disorganized, while the resulting output laser radiation is highly ordered and thus has lower entropy. So highly entropic energy is therefore converted into less entropic energy within the laser. So active laser medium are available in all aggregate states, solid, liquid and gas. So whatever the things is happening when the certain pumping was done, So when the pumping was done, due to the help of a mirrors, it is to be get accelerated. So what is meant by an LBM? So it is an laser machining is localized non-contact machining and is almost reaction force free. So the photon energy is absorbed by the target material. So photon rays is to be getting in the form of a thermal energy or a photochemical energy. So here the material is removed by melting and blown away. So whatever I had told you in the thermal machining process, whatever the material is, it is to be get melted. It is not directly the tool is to be moving on the workpiece. So long pulsed and a continuous wave lasers or by direct vaporization, ablation, ultra short pulsed lasers. So here the laser machine consists of laser, mirrors or a fiber for beam guidance. So focusing optics and positioning system. So these are the machine which are to be get consists of. So with the help of the main thing, with the help of a mirrors only, which are placed beside the active beam, the total operation is going to be get done with the help of a mirrors only. So the laser beam is focused onto the workpiece and it is moved relative to it. The laser machining process is controlled by switching the laser on and off. It is not directly, the laser is not continuously started. And the laser pulse energy and other laser parameters and other by positioning either the workpiece or the laser focus. So any material that can be properly absorb the laser irradiation can be laser machined. So we can use the hard and brittle materials as well as the soft materials. And the laser beam machining process is very, very expensive. It is not a normal thing. It is a very expensive. It is only used in some industries, highly industries, when a perfect production is to be get done. So the working principles. So what is the working principles you are going to be having? So before seeing the working principle, we will see what is the animation video so that we will get an idea. So you already seen that the electric energy, because we are going to pumping some power supply to the light energy and it is converted to the heat energy. So the workpiece and the lens, what I had told you, it is placed fixture. It is a partially reflected surface which is made up of a chromium and it is a total reflected surface. The bottom is a partial reflected surface, the top is a total reflected surface, and these are the two mirrors which are beside of the part. And the power supply is to be given. So ruby crystal dipped with a chromium. It is a ruby crystal dipped with a chromium. So when the power supply is to be given to the both the mirrors, it is to be get accelerated. Some electrons, beams, the photons are to be get generated towards the ruby crystal. And it is transforming with the help of a partially reflected surface and to the lenses towards the workpiece. So here it is known as a photochemical machining process. This part is known as a photochemical machining process because here it is the photons are to be get generated, where in an EBM it is the electrons are to be get generated. So clear students, so this is a LBM. So now we will see what is the principle. So you have seen that some electrical energy is to be get converted to the light. And after the light, it is to be get converted into the heat. So as a laser interacts with the material, the energy of the photon is absorbed by the work material, leading to rapid substantial rise in the local temperature. So this in turn results in melting and vaporization of the work material, and finally the material is removed. So clear, the first one is the laser interacts with the material, the energy of photon is absorbed by the work material. So what is happening? So when the power supply was given, it was to be going to the mirrors, and with the help of a mirrors, and in the middle of the mirrors we had placed a ruby crystal. So when the mirrors are to be get accelerated towards the ruby crystal, the photons are to be get generated, and one is a partial reflected surface. So from when the photons are generated, it is moving to the partially reflected surface and to the lens and to the workpiece. Clear? So the next one. So this is a material removal mechanism. So one is a laser beam. It is an absorption and heating. How it is going to get done? And what is a melting? And what is a vaporization? So in the absorption heating, well, starting stage. It is not a final stage. It is a starting stage. What is the thermal conduction you are getting? What is the laser beam it is producing? So when the melting, so this totally explains about the workpiece. Totally explains about the workpiece. So when the laser beams are to be getting, so how it is to be get melting? Liquid and a solid-liquid interface and a solid. Next, the vaporization process, the material is to be get removed. The laser beam is to be accelerated towards the workpiece. Here. So always think this is a workpiece. This is a workpiece. Here, this is a workpiece. Here, this is a process. What we are telling is, it is when it is done on the workpiece. So what is the type of lasers can be used? Types of lasers. It is a carbon dioxide. It is a neodymium, yttrium, aluminium, garnet. It is a combination of these all. So it is a glass and a ruby, neodymium, glass and a ruby, and a diode and an excimer. So these are the laser beam selection guide. So it explains that when the drilling operation is to be done, if we want to drill the small holes, large holes, or a drilling precision or tree pan, so when these type of drilling is to be get done, what type of laser light is to be get used? Because we have seen here more types of lasers. So what type of lasers are to be get used? So for a small holes, ruby. So for the large holes, what type of? So the same thing when cutting was done. So what type of cutting? Thick cutting, thin slitting, or plastics. So what type of laser type is to be get used? So it is CO2 plus gas resistance. It is CO2. So what is the type of materials, metals, organics and non-metals, and ceramics? So what type of laser light is to be get used? So laser beam applications are, it is a material removal, welding, cladding, and alloying. So these are the main applications which comes under the laser beam machining. So advantages, tool wear and breakage are not encountered. So holes can be located accurately by using an optical laser system for alignment. So very small holes. Students, it is 10:55. Okay,